Hey, what's up guys, welcome to Laratips. I have been getting a lot of questions in the comment section and also messages in my Instagram that how do I use Alias for the several commands. For example, let me show you. So instead of typing php artisan like this, we can just write pa like this and it will automatically work as php artisan. For now, I have removed whatever setup that I have done. For example, let's say if I write php artisan like this, then it will show me the list of all the commands that are available in the Laravel. But if I type PA, now it is showing me this command not found. And this JSH is another terminal that I have installed. But by default, there will be the bash terminal in the Linux. And if you want this bash terminal in your Windows, then you can also install it from this link. And I'll be leaving the link just below that like button. And for Mac, I don't think you need to download anything, and I haven't used Mac OS, so I cannot tell about that, but I have used Windows before, and at that time I would just download this git bash and just use the aliases by creating it. Now let me show you how to create an alias. In the Linux, you just need to go to the home of your terminal. So just type cd and hit enter, then it will take you to this home. So if I just type pwd, this is working directory. So it will show me here home/assis, and it will show you home/your username, and it is the same thing for macOS. And for the Windows, you can just go to cd/user/ and your whatever your username is, just go inside that. And I think most of you will have the nano editor. You can just use that when you are using terminal, but I have Vim installed. I can also use that, but I think many of you will have nano, so I'll use nano over here. And now you need to create a file name as .bash.rc. just do touch.bash.rc and hit on enter. I already have this file with me, so I don't need to create this. Now to open this file, I'll say nano, and if you are using Windows, then you can just create .bash.rc file using the UI of the Windows. So here we'll do nano.bash.rc like this, and I'll hit enter. Now it will open the file, and let me just go at the bottom. Now to create an alias for php artisan, I'll just write here alias pa equals to php artisan like this. But I'd recommend you to create a separate file .alias for all the alias that you want to have in your system. So I'll just remove it from here. And you can see here I have already created that file before, so we can import a file like this. This file is present in the same directory where I have this .bash.rc file. So I'll write dot, and this tilde will give us the home directory, then /.alias. So I'll just close it, and as I have already said that I have already created that .alias file, so I'll just open that vi.alias. And you can see here I have created a bunch of alias over here. And before, I just commented this php artisan alias. Now I'll just uncomment it, and you can write the alias like this. Just write alias space whatever the name of the alias, pa let's say here, and equal to this inverted comma php artisan. So instead of writing now php artisan, we can write pa. So I'll just write and close. Now I'll go to my project here. Now I'll type here pa. Now also it is not working. And also guys, I told you to use .alias file, separate file for all the aliases, because let's say you are using ZSS terminal. So in my case, I'm using ZSS terminal. Then you can just import that alias file in that ZSSRC configuration file. Then it will work the same way. You don't have to just copy and paste all the aliases. So now currently it is not working, because whenever we do any changes in the bash.rc file, then we need to again reopen the terminal. So I'll just open a new tab over here, and it opened me in the same project here like this. So now I'll write pa, then it has opened all the commands that are present in this Laravel project. And also let me go here in this tab, and let me show you one more thing guys. I have installed ZSS terminal, so the configuration name is zss.rc, so bhi.zssrc, and here also I have just imported that same alias. So whether I'm using bash or ZSS, I'll be able to get the same aliases. So that's the benefit of writing aliases on a separate file. So that's it for this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you want me to create some other videos, then just let me know in the comment section below, and I'll be creating videos that you want. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.